the battle right now. I know you're in a struggle right now. I know you're in a storm right now. But tell us, keep your praise now. Keep your praise now. Because the battle is a God. Touch the neighbor. Say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Say, oh, neighbor. Tell them, don't worry. Tell them, the battle is over. But tell them,
He said the enemy that you've seen today,
come on here.
You shall see them again no more would have been good enough for me then. But then he said forever. Thank you, like Alice in Wonderland. He said, "Now what did he just say?" Okay. No, sir. He said, "Fear not.
Come on.
Stand still. See the salvation of the Lord, which He will show you today."
Yes.
If I was in the children of Israel, I'd have passed out right there. That would have been good enough. Because when you've been servants to the Egyptians, you've been held in captivity, you've been bound in slavery, all that long. You mean God gonna show me this today? Well, what if I was to tell you, those of you that God has prophesied to you, that you're going to be millionaires, that by the time you check your P.O. box next time, it was gonna be waiting on you? How would you act then? As a prophet of the Lord tonight, that the Lord said that this is your season of manifestation. What if I was to tell you that the Lord said you are going to embrace the very thing that you lost? I'm prophesying to you, lady. Because there's some things that were stripped from you. There's some things that were taken from you. You literally watched the enemy walk away with your stuff. But God said over the next 6 months, you're getting ready to receive it all back with interest. All back with interest. This is your season of manifestation. God wants you to know tonight that you ain't gonna see this problem no more. But it's a mindset thing. Because these children of Israel say we would have been better off staying in Egypt. We would have been better off staying in Egypt. That's like if every African American just decided to come together and say, you know what, we would have been better off in Africa. Is you crazy? Is you cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs? Come on here. They said we would have been better off in Egypt than to die in the wilderness. Well, who told you was going to die?
That's right.
See, that's what happens when we come up with our own conclusion.
That's right.
That's what happens when we walk by sight and not by faith. You come up with your own conclusion. Some of you tonight need to ask God to forgive you for coming up with your own conclusion. Because when you come up with your own conclusion, you doubt the power of God. You doubt what God can really do.
That's right.
Come on, some of y'all, you know, I used to tell my sister all the time, my sister is a real tight budgeter. And my sister, I mean, she I thought I was bad, but my sister, she calculates every, she registers, you know, a checkbook. She balances her checkbook down to the penny. Wait a minute. My account should have 63 more cents than what it's got in here. Where is the 63 cents? I said, it ain't that serious. Because something ain't right. You know? But when we get to a point to where we come up with our own conclusions, I was telling the church on last night about sowing a seed. Amen. Some people wouldn't sow the seed, and the Lord allowed me to hear one particular lady say, well, I got to pay my rent by the third. Okay, now, what if you don't think God can move for you by the third of the next month?
I know it.
Come on here. And so we come up with our own conclusion, then that tells God, I already got this figured out.
Come on out.
I don't need your help. But at the same time, we saying, help me, Lord, but I already got to figure it out. Why do you want God to intervene in what you're doing and you already got to figure it out? When you walk by faith, you never know what's going to happen.
Amen.
Some people tell me, they say, son, you're 29 years old. You know, your life should be planned out. You should have a roadmap. You should. I can't have no roadmap with the calling that's on my life because I don't know what God wants me to do.
Man.
3 months I'm in L.A., then I'm back in Florida.
That's right.
3 months I'm down in West Palm Beach and I'm back in Lake Wales.
Yeah.
I don't know where I'm going to be the next 3 months. Mm-hmm. It's not unstable. Mm-hmm. It's because with the calling that's on my life, I have to be able to do what God wants me to do.
Right.
And God don't want me in no one place forever.
Right.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Yeah. So I've learned to get over that. Amen.
Yeah.
I've learned to stop trying to figure it out myself.
That's right.
Yeah. My sister tell me all the time. She say, because see, stuff like that don't bother you. It don't. Mm-hmm. I had an anxiety attack in 2001. Mm-hmm. That was the first one, and that was the last one.
Yeah.
I don't stress about nothing. I would be lying if I didn't say the human side of me don't kick up from time to time. But there is nothing that I stress out about more than 15 to 20 minutes.
I know.
You can ask my family, they'll tell you. I don't let stuff bother me like that because I ain't ready to die yet.
Right.
And I ain't going to let nothing got to do with no money especially kill me.
Right.
I ain't going to let nothing got to do with no relationship kill me.
All right.
Come on here.
Man.
Amen. Man. People will ruin their life over a man like it ain't like millions of other men in the world.
Right.
But you'll ruin your life going, trying to get revenge and all this kind of thing. It ain't worth it.
It ain't worth it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So we've got to stop coming up with our own conclusion. They said, we told you to let us stay with the Egyptians than to come and die in the wilderness. See, Moses is a lot better than me. I'm glad I wasn't living back then.
That's right.
And God didn't call me to lead them. Because I was telling them, y'all go back to Egypt then. I'm going on where God tells me to go. Y'all want to go to Egypt? Y'all stay in Egypt. I'll see y'all next time.
That's right.
You know? Come on. Mm-hmm. Amen. But God is so infinite in this wisdom. Stop coming up with it. If I don't say anything else to you tonight, I want to say stop coming up with your own